Starting to the bottom left of the map, in red we have the StarTail Protoss player. It is
StarTail Avenger.
Avenge in a rough spot here, needs a win, and his opponent to the top right, chipmunk like he is.
MVP Noblesse.
His old ID was cute, for you, so.
MVP Noblesse, he's also on Twitter. Make sure that you add him. And he certainly made an impression today. He did it in the past too. His Twitter ID is MVP Noblesse. No underscores, no nothing. Just plain and simple, MVP Noblesse, as you can see him to the top right. So definitely add him. He only has 2,000 followers. A player that is this successful, not only in Code A, but also on the verge of getting into Code S, definitely deserves a little bit more attention. Send him a tweet. He speaks English well enough to understand what you write him. So this guy definitely... needs a little bit more exposure here.
Yeah, I could agree with you entirely there. If you want to follow us at ProxyWolf and at Kaldor. I want to tell you guys a secret about Kaldor.
About me?
Yeah, what Kaldor does during these matches, he's looking up stats, he's doing a lot of good things, he's talking about the group standing, but also he peels oranges and then eats them during the 5-minute breaks. It's a secret.
Yeah.
It's now known to everybody. Everybody knows what you do now.
Peeling the oranges calms me down. It gives my hands something to do.
Yeah, like what I do actually is dismantle paper cups.
Yeah, exactly. I was looking for a paper cup earlier because I wanted to put the orange thingies in there that I peel off. And I was looking for one. I was like, wait a second, Wolf actually always has one. And I looked to the right, and there are all these dismantled, dismembered paper cups. And I'm like, well, that doesn't really help me.
Well, here's one here. I have one that I haven't dismantled yet.
Okay,
it has,
thank you.
It has some coffee residue in it, but I don't think orange peels
fine.
Are mine.
No. The orange peels are going to be fine here. That helps me a lot. Thank you.
But that just goes to show you guys, people at the GSL here have weird habits that they do during the games.
We definitely do. Tasis, for example, always leaves his stuff behind.
Yeah.
And we are the ones who have to deal with that the next time we cast. I actually started hiding his, what is that actually that he has? He has
thermos.
His bottle. Yeah, the thermos. I actually started hiding it because I'm like, okay, Nick, if you can't clean up after you, I will teach you. I will hide those thermoses. And he was walking around the studio the last time. I was like, somebody stole my thermos. And like, man, have you seen it? I'm like, no, I have no idea where it is.
I can't believe you just said this on air. Someone's going to tell him.
No, nobody's going to tell him. It's going to be our secret. We're talking a bit about Noblesse. We are talking a bit about Noblesse already, but I also want to give Avenge a bit of a shout out. He didn't have an easy time in this group. But if you are a StarTail fan and you want to support one of the few Protoss players that they have left in their roster, add him on Twitter too, send him a tweet. If you're a StarTail fan, you should have already followed him. But if you didn't, now you know about his Twitter ID. It's StarTail _ Avenge. It's actually exactly the ID that you can see at the top left for both of them. So if you want to add them, make sure to do that.
The weird build, it's the Hellion build, and the thing is, seeing is believing, and when
half the battle, that's what you were looking for.
Yeah, seeing is believing, and when you see those Hellions, you believe. You know, if someone told Avenge, whispered in his ears, that Noblesse is going to react to Hellions and Terran vs. Protoss and cross spawns on Whirlwind, Avenge would say, well, Whirlwind's a good map for this, but I just don't believe you. But when he sees it now, now he knows he's going to need to defend this. This is going to be difficult. In fact, he's not going to be able to mine from his natural for a long time.
Yeah. It's definitely going to be a little bit tricky here. Pylon, he's setting up those pylons everywhere. He wants to see if there's a medivac that comes in and where exactly so that he can react. So it's a bit of a warning system that he's trying to put in place.
A reactor Hellions can only do so much for you in this matchup, but what they've accomplished already for Noblesse is stopping the Protoss mining at the natural, and now he's going to run in and see, are there any sentries I can kill? Did you neglect my warning of the reactor factory? Did you put probes on there? If you did,
I think
I'll punish
that might have happened.
Well, he doesn't put any probes down there yet.
No, not just yet. Ah, another scout is going in. Did he see it though?
No.
Didn't see the command center.
Saw the bunker, though.
Yeah, saw the bunker, but he does not know for a fact that there's a command center at this point.
Robo goes up now, and at this point he's just like, well, I guess those are the last Hellions I'm going to see.
Yeah.
Did nothing except delay mining, and now he can move his probes down. He has nothing else.
Well, there's one of the little things happening. I want to just tell you one thing again. We talked about this during the GSTL cast, and a surprising number of people tweeted us and told us that they actually didn't know that. If you were ever wondering, when you look at our overlay here, the score overlay, what the P7 and the T1 means, it's actually pretty simple. P7 stands for StarTail Avenged Race, which is Protoss, and the 7 is his starting position at 7 o'clock. And the same is, of course, also true for Noblesse. He's Terran and he's starting at the 1 o'clock position on this map. It's something that apparently a lot of people don't really know, so if you're ever wondering about it, now you do.
Yeah, now it's known to you.
Yeah, sometimes we forget that a lot of people are tuning in that don't have a lot of StarCraft 2 experience just yet, so we are trying to do this every now and then now, just give you a few hints about this to make the appearance a little bit more enjoyable.
Raise the awareness. These Hellions are still hanging out here at the bottom of the ramp, and there's not much Avenge can do about it just yet. Noblesse is going to push with a small Bio Force, and with the Hellions, extra splash damage. Even though Hellions, if you look at the help menu, it says they're bad against Stalkers, they add a lot of extra DPS, and any Sentries or Zealots that get caught in that splash damage are going to take even more.
Do you remember the crazy times with the old Blue Flame upgrade when Hellions were basically good against everything?
Yes.
You just had to build enough of them?
Do you remember, well, hold that thought. See, this is just enough Stalkers versus Hellions that the Hellions can't fight, but if he had the bio with him, this would have been disastrous.
Yeah, exactly. It's also Avenge now going into the double forge. The upgrades have already been started for Noblesse, who's now walking across the map and trying to put on the aggression, but Avenge really wants to have not only the forge for the upgrades, but with the Colossus, he could be able to defend against us a lot better.
I was going to ask you if you remember when Roaches did not have range to deal with Hellions, and Hellions could kite Roaches.
I try to not think about these days.
I was already switched to Protoss at that time, this matchup did not affect me.
I remember when Roaches had one supply. That was the good old times.
I did not enjoy it. This drop somehow goes undetected.
How did that happen?
Well, he's...
He has another force at the front,
Avenge is
knocking
totally,
at the doorstep.
He's totally...
Oblivious to this.
Yeah, he's like bouncing back and forth like a tennis ball, but he's not actually dealing with either of the problems.
He's losing a lot
he's
here.
He's not splitting his units, he's just one-aing either way.
Yeah, Avenge now suddenly leaves his natural completely exposed. Look at this,
wow,
all those
this
Marauders.
This is terrible splitting here.
This could actually be game. Look
I
at how much he
be.
Takes down here. He kills everything. Maybe the Colossus is able to save Avenge's life, but this is devastating.
Well, he's not mining at all at his main base. And
16 harvesters have been killed.
He's going to lose his pylon, and then Noblesse is just going to bounce out. Oh, this Colossus!
Oh,
that
wow.
was a sick save.
That was a good force field. That was very close. I actually thought the Colossus would be gone.
That medevac shows that she doesn't need speed upgrades. She's all natural.
She's French.
Exactly. The Valkyrie pilot is German, just like the StarCraft 1, I think.
Really?
I think so.
Might be.
Avenge now has the upgrades coming, but he doesn't have a large enough army. Yeah, he's got Colossi, but Colossi cannot stand alone. They're like a man on stilts. You know, if you're not used to walking around like that by yourself, you're going to fall over probably.
That is actually true.
It's the best analogy I can think of at the spur of the moment, but... Now the third base up for Noblesse, and Avenge can't move out even with these powerful Colossi without support units. He lost so many gateway units during this attack, he lost a lot of probes as well. He needs time to recuperate, and Noblesse just gets stronger and stronger. He's even making a bunker at his third base, so no Zealot run bys are going to affect him.
The fact alone that he has a third is already crazy.
Yeah.
He's so far ahead in this game, he has a third base that is being saturated, and there is no hope. You know, Avenge doesn't get out of his corner. He's at the corner, the bottom left of Whirlwind, he just doesn't get out.
Yeah. Avenge is totally trapped. He can't do anything with those Colossi until he has support for them. He even has good upgrades coming out, but that doesn't matter unless he has units to be upgraded. His unit count right now is 2 Colossi, 6 Stalkers, 5 Zealots, and 2 Sentries. His opponent has multiple Medivacs, Vikings, 8 Marauders, 14 Marines.
He's pulling 4 Vikings at a time and he already has 3, which means in a few seconds he will have 7 to take down 2 Colossi. That's numbers in Noblesse's favor. He is dominating this match so hard, it is scary.
Yeah. Noblesse is the creator of this group. I mean, if you look at the other group the creator was in, I think that was group A. It was either A or B.
I think it was B. Yeah, it was definitely B. A was the Stefano group.
Right, that's correct. And he totally dominated it. It looked like no one could touch him. And Noblesse is doing the same thing to this group.
Yeah. Creator definitely pulled an MC Hammer in that group.
I mean, this is not like, well, Noblesse has a slight lead and... it's going to be difficult for Avenge. It's like Noblesse is 30% ahead, no, 50% ahead in supply right now. Even more, as he rapidly hits his macro perfectly. These Colossi are out in the middle of nowhere. Noblesse could have snatched them up.
The only thing that you can really say about Noblesse, where he maybe slipped up a little bit, is his upgrades. The armory is a bit late, he didn't start +2/+2 yet, and this is one of the advantages that Avenge will have. His +2/+2 is nearly complete, and he will be a full set of upgrades ahead of his opponent.
The army supply right now is 99-56. The Viking count, as you mentioned before, is... it's certainly going to make those Colossi topple. Here we go! Vikings are going on 3 sentries and a stalker. A few other stalkers come out from hiding, but I don't think so either.
Those Colossi, they don't have a good time here. The first one is already gone, the second one about to go down. The sentries are being taken apart.
No charge. The stalkers are about to have blink, but all they can do is blink on top of bio forces that'll cut them to shreds. The last Colossus is going to follow these Vikings. The +2 armor helping out quite a bit, though.
Yeah, and this is it nonetheless. I mean, at this point, we don't have any Colossi anymore. There comes the bio force stimming through.
Nobody can stop this guy today. Noblesse, he's not in Codex yet, even with this, but I can't imagine if somebody cut his arms off, he wouldn't make it through.
At this point, I really think this is going... he has to advance. This
drops
is crazy.
Drops the mule.
He drops the mule hammer here. He tells his opponent, well, it has been fun, but now get out of my game.
Stalkers blink up to die, and the Nexi are falling.
GG. Avenge is down. He's in Code A, he cannot get third place in this group anymore. He cannot advance to Code S. He had a good run, but today his opponents were too strong. He's 1-3 in the group. Noblesse just took his fourth win. And this means we have 3 players still in the runner for the 2 Code S spots and also for the third place. It is Noblesse leading with 4-0. It is Crazy and Boong Boong, both of them, with a 3-1. The next game originally would have been Labyrinth versus Alive, but both of them are already out of the competition. They can't reach the third place anymore, and they can't advance to Codex. Therefore, the game is not going to be played. The next match that we are going to have is going to be Boong Boong versus Noblesse. And as soon as, well, we have another 5-minute break, as soon as we are back, we have Boong Boong versus Noblesse. This is going to be the final test for Noblesse. If he wins, he is definitely going to be in
5-0.
Yeah, 5-0 in the groups. It's like, yeah, I want everything, so I guess I'm through. But yeah, we're going to find out if we can pull through here. See you guys in 5 minutes.